Michael Jackson wrongful death trial new at 6. Jackson's former physician took the witness stand today, one day after his video deposition was shown to the court. As Eyewitness News reporter Miriam Hernandez tells us, jurors are expected to begin deliberations next week.
It was in 1996, during the history tour, that Michael Jackson's struggle with insomnia became abundantly clear to his longtime physician. He testified the entertainer was so adrenalized it was days before he could sleep. He says Jackson was in a similar creative frenzy when he wrote the song that raised millions to fight famine. Dr. Allan Metzger told jurors that under his care in earlier years, Jackson was able to sleep with traditional sleep medications, but then other doctors overprescribed for the star. Catherine Jackson alleges that Jackson's tour promoters, AEG, negligently supervised Conrad Murray, who is now serving time for causing Jackson's death. The AEG defense says Jackson's use of meds was his personal choice. Jackson's habit with pain meds was spotlighted in a video deposition presented by the AEG defense yesterday. Metzger said he heard this from four sources, including Jackson's wife, Debbie Rowe, and two other doctors.
That Michael was doctor shopping and took pain medication that the average person wouldn't.
Today, the doctor testified that doctor shopping to him meant Jackson shopped for the best qualified doctors when he was traveling outside Los Angeles. Metzger testified that he advised Jackson 2 months before his death that the use of the anesthetic propofol was potentially life-threatening. But Metzger said he couldn't remember a previous instance when he allegedly prescribed propofol himself. Debbie Rowe testified that in 1997 that Metzger enlisted two doctors in Germany to administer propofol in a hotel room to the star, where they came equipped with monitoring equipment. The defense displayed a letter indicating Metzger ordered it.
Do you remember having a conversation with either or both of these gentlemen about assisting Mr. Jackson with his sleep?
Never.
Never.
The Jackson attorneys planned to have Metzger offer an explanation today, but the judge ruled that the Jackson attorneys violated court rules by improperly sharing information with a doctor. They were barred from inquiring about it. Dr. Metzger returns to the stand tomorrow. The plan for the court is still to have closing arguments begin next week. Miriam Hernandez, ABC 7 Eyewitness News.